When an opportunity is closed, either because you've won the project or you've lost it, and you then need to build a new opportunity, either for renewal, for a follow-on work, or whatever. So this is going to show you a process to be able to automatically clone opportunities. So we're going to go out to setup, and we're going to look at flows. And because there's some things here missing, I want to talk about. Let's go in. Actually, we're seeing that this is part of the process automation section. So if we go in on just the full list and find process automation, we can still get to flows here. What it also shows us is this new automation home feature. And if we go out to that, know that we now have access to this, which is a great link to be able to get additional information. There's, metrics and things to show you what the activity's been. It also gives you a create button, which gives you a sense that they're seeing Flows Process Builder. It kind of this is the order in which to kind of learn more about these, because this is the priority of how you should be using them. Good to see. Now, if we go back out just quickly to flows. You also, because there's another video we did look talking about this, but it's important to build out a new list controls view. And what you can do is create a view here, and it always defaults to all. But if you go to flows and development, what this will do is the two keys are you can wrap text, which means you can see a full title for the name of the flow. It also, you can see kind of last modified dates. And I like this one now because this shows me whether or not I've got an older version that I'm using. And this is a full set of the descriptions, and this will show you kind of what information is out there, especially as you kind of float between them. It gives you the full description, which is quite nice. And this is how you get to the flow details and versions. That's again kind of very important. But let's say I'm going to create a new flow. And what it does is it brings up a screen that says, great, here's your options. And so as we're talking about automating this opportunity, kind of cloning, building a new one, we can do it as a screen flow. Lots of great examples of how to launch a screen flow with components, that kind of thing, Lightning components. But if we want to auto launch, is every time it happens, we want to create it. That's different. So we're going to call both of these flows, but they are different. So if we look at a screen flow, they have screens. If we look out at an auto launch flow, there's no more screen element because there's no interaction with a person where a screen is actually interacting with a person. So again, if we look at the screen and we drag in a subflow, this is another distinction because you'll see there's lots of choices, including the auto launch flow. That we're going to be talking about. So here's the auto launch here. We're going to get to it. Is this one right here is an auto launch. And so I'm going to close this for now. We're going to go back over here. And if I pull in the subflows here, this is with the auto launch. I can use only auto launch flows. And so, that's an important distinction between the two. So yeah, if I have to launch an auto launch, how do I do that? Well, if we go back out to, and this is using the full list, I can go to Process Builder here, or if I'm using the new automation home, I could create a Process Builder here. And what it's going to do is take me to my Process Builders. And what I want to do is to go in here. I could click new and build it, but instead what I'm going to do is to click here, and it's going to pull up this Opportunity 3 clone. And again, this is just if an opportunity is closed and there is a field that's called is closed. And if it's true, then I'm going to do the action. And what I'm going to do for my action is flows. And what I can do is to say, let's just call a cloning flow, and then I get just the choice of the auto flows. And if I choose one, let's say I select this one, then what I do get is the option to create, to set flow variables. And so if I want to pass information into this flow, that's the way I'm going to be able to do that. Like record ID, we're going to do that differently. The other thing I think is helpful, there's a good document out here that talks about flow types, and it shows what a screen flow is and what an auto launch flow is. What you'll see is there's two overlapping here. The custom buttons and visual force pages, we can do custom buttons and we can do visual force pages from either one, but plenty of distinctions between the two. Hope that's helpful. And now what we're going to do is we're going to drop in on this flow and talk about how we actually would create a renewal opportunity and how we would make the assignments. So thanks for watching and look forward to the next version.